Wondering which is a better tool for you, Notion or xTiles? Both tools are well known for being a great all-in-one solution for anything from planning, task management, brainstorming, and more. In this video, we wanted to dive into the pros and cons of each one while comparing various features like ease of use, collaboration, and more. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. The first aspect we'll be comparing is ease of use. So with the case of Notion, it could be pretty intimidating at first. So here we have Notion, and if you have an empty page like this, it could be really confusing how you're even supposed to start. So if you type slash, you can find all sorts of options here that you can get started with, and then you can start adding things in here. And once you start learning how the block-based system works, it can get quite easy to use. But at the same time, there's just so much that can be done in Notion that it could be a bit intimidating. Notion does allow you to have some options to get started with to avoid this empty page issue. So for example, you could simply click templates and then get started with a template. And if you'd like, you can also click here. And then let's say you just want to create a to-do list, you could simply click one of these and get started as well. And then you can see your pages inside of the sidebar and so on. So in terms of getting started in ease of use, Notion might have a bit of a learning curve, but overall, you can also use some of the tools Notion provides to kind of avoid having an empty page. Next, if we go over to xTiles, you'll notice that in order to create a new project, you simply have to click plus new project, and you can either use a template or start from scratch. So similar to Notion, you can either use a template to make things easier or just start from scratch. If you were to start from scratch, it's quite intuitive in the way that you need to set this up. So you immediately have this kind of grid-based format that many of you might be familiar with in terms of how it might work. So you just simply drag a block like this and you can get started. For example, to-do list, and then here you could start by adding checklist like this. So it is a bit intuitive to start with xTiles because you can really just move things around, so it's kind of more visual, and you can create more boxes, add more things here. So in terms of just straight getting started, you just want to brainstorm, you want to create a to-do list, this kind of thing, xTiles could be great for that. Next, we wanted to cover some collaborative features. So both xTiles and Notion have collaboration as a key element. And if we are in Notion, for example, if you want to share your page with other people, all you have to do is click share, and then you can add people by email. And Notion's quite generous in that you can add multiple people in as guests. So you don't have to necessarily have a paid plan in order to have guests accessing the Notion page. And the other thing that's quite useful is this new update where you can click the three dots here and then add suggested edits. So you can start suggesting things by simply adding in your changes, and then after you're done, it can be sort of an option whether or not you want to change this. So if you, for example, you want to delete this and then call this instead project and task manager, and then you're done suggesting, you can turn it off. You can now see that there was a suggested comment to change it to this, and you can click this to get it away. And then here we wanted to delete project, so we can also approve that as well. So this is a really useful collaborative feature if you're working among multiple people and making edits. And you can also add people properties. So if we click one open and you want to assign this project to other people, you can also do that through Notion. If we go to xTiles, xTiles also has a robust collaborative element, and people might want to sort of compare it to Miro in the sense that you can actually in real time work together, move things around and so on. And if you want to share, you can simply go to share and then you can invite through email address similar to Notion. And also, again, you have a guest limit of 10 people, which is quite generous. You can also assign tasks as well. So if we have a task here and you wanted to assign this task, you can actually go ahead and click here, and then you can click this person button and then assign it and apply. So in that sense, you can also do things like that with task management, which kind of gives a little bit more possibilities for collaboration. The next thing we wanted to cover is how both apps handle task management. In this case, both have a centralized task system. So if we go to the sidebar and we go to Notion Home, you can see that we have, for example, here a task list that brings up all the tasks from various areas of the workspace, which is really useful so that you can actually see multiple task databases all in one space. And then one thing to note with Notion also is that if you want to have a space for task management, you do have to build it yourself or use a template. So whenever you have sort of some tasks here, you'll notice that all of these properties and these things have been built from scratch at some point. So this can be a little bit confusing. So there's no real task system built in, but you have to purposely connect it to Notion Home's tasks. With xTiles, on the other hand, it's already automated in the sense that there is a universal task inbox. So if we click here for tasks, you can see all the tasks that are there from various other projects. So in that sense, you basically see everything here, no matter what project you're in. So if this is your daily planner or you have another project, which is a team planner, something like that, you'll see all of your tasks here like this. So this can be handy and useful, especially if you're putting tasks everywhere around your projects. It could be nice to be able to simply click here and see everything. So the next thing we wanted to talk about is how calendars are handled in both of these apps. So calendars are a really central part of staying productive and organized. And in this case, we have our project and task manager as an example. But basically, if we go to our calendars database here, you can see that in Notion, you basically have a calendar like this, and it's kind of working independently of each other. So you basically have a team calendar, then you'll have a task calendar. But if you want to see all of different databases all in the same place, you'll actually have to use Notion Calendar, which basically ties everything together. So this is kind of a not the best aspect in terms of Notion, in that it doesn't have a native Google Calendar integration, but using Notion Calendar does alleviate some of that. So let's say that we added an event in the team calendar and we see in the projects nothing showing up here. So these are separate calendars, so you'll have to actually configure them in Notion Calendar. You can also now see it inside Notion Home as well if you configure it correctly, the Notion Calendar. So that's another way to see everything. But in terms of having the flexibility to see multiple databases in one place, that is still not something that you can do in Notion. And on top of that, to see your Google Calendar. On the other hand, with xTiles, you do get a sort of global calendar view here, but it's only limited to tasks. So if you add a new task, you'll see them show up in your calendar like this. So it's basically similar to the global tasks that you can see. But if you do add a calendar collection like this and then blank calendar, and then you add an entry inside, it doesn't necessarily show up into the global calendar. So if we click here and then we click the global calendar, you won't see anything in here. But if we add a new task inside of here and then schedule it to be tomorrow, then we'll now see it inside of the calendar over here. And if you don't want to see the task in this calendar, you can go to the gear icon here and then toggle it off. Next, let's talk about the visual customizations for Notion and xTiles. So if we're in this Ultimate Project and Task Manager in Notion, you can see that we can choose the cover photos here, and then you can also choose different icons. You can also upload custom icons, and Notion also has this huge custom icon library. And in terms of colors, with Notion, you can choose various colors like this, and it's quite standardized in the sense that you can't really choose outside of these colors, but we found that we really like this aesthetic with Notion. And the other thing is it kind of has this layout where you don't really see other things here, but they're all on the edges like this. But if we go to xTiles, one thing that might bother some people is this kind of tab format. So instead of being able to hide this kind of thing into a sidebar, you have to kind of organize your pages into these tabs, which can be also easier to navigate. So it just depends on the preference. In terms of design choices, you can go to this button here and you have a lot of customizations for each of your tiles. So you can do various things like this. And you can change the colors based on xTiles' own color scheme. You can also choose different kinds of layouts like this and do other things. So it's quite interesting how you can customize in xTiles. If you want to add custom colors, you can also do so. So this gives a lot of customization options so that you can really be in control of your colors. But this is also a plus plan feature. In Notion, it's actually impossible to actually choose your custom color. So no matter if you have a paid plan. So this could be a kind of feature that some people might really like. Another visual element with xTiles is that you always have this sort of grid to show sort of where you put your things. So if you have everything filled in, you won't see this grid, but if you have some empty spaces, you might notice this grid. Next, let's talk about the difference between databases and collections. So both Notion and xTiles use a system to hold all of your data, which xTiles calls collections and Notion seems to call databases. And here we have an example of a database for you. So this is, for example, where you hold each of your projects inside. And with Notion, what's great is that the databases you can basically transform into different views and you have quite a lot of options. So these are all free as well. So you can do things like put them into a table, a board view, a timeline, calendar list, gallery, and even charts. So this is a really useful feature. You can also click here and then go to group and then group things based on, for example, the priority like this. And it's just very flexible in that you have a lot of choices on how to actually organize your data inside of Notion. The other really big element about this kind of Notion's database system is that you can reference this database anywhere, and when you make a change, it's going to be reflected here. So here we have stored all of our databases. So if we go to our projects, you can see the exact same thing here, except that now we can actually pull this up into the main dashboard. So if we wanted to show any kind of database here, we can do /linked view so that we can add an existing database to this page and then we would choose the correct database to show. So this makes it really nice to create your own sort of dashboards. If we go over to xTiles, instead of these kinds of databases that you can link into the main page, xTiles treats it as a new page. So if we click plus here, you can add a new collection. So just like Notion, you have, for example, gallery view, and you can see this inside of a gallery. But if you want to reference this gallery in the main page, one option is just to copy the link to view, and then you can just paste it in here. And although it's kind of inconvenient, you can just click here and then go to this gallery view. But there's no real way to show this exact gallery view inside of your main dashboard if you wanted to treat it as a main dashboard. So instead, with xTiles, we would recommend you to just keep all of your databases in separate tabs and then keep this as sort of a place where you can hold like information that's not relating to a database. So the next thing we wanted to share with you is the share to web functions for Notion and xTiles. So with Notion, especially with the new Notion Sites update, there's a lot of robust features for sharing to the web. So if we go ahead and click share here, and you were to publish it as a web page, you can hit publish and then you can get this link that you can share anywhere. And you can also turn on search engine indexing, and there's also things like link inspiration and more like site customization with different headers. xTiles, on the other hand, if you want to share it to the web, you would click share just like in Notion, and then you can toggle on share to web. And then at that point, you have the option for allow request to editing, allow duplicating. And if you upgrade, you have the search engine indexing, but it is kind of basic in its shareability features compared to Notion. Finally, let's go ahead and compare the pricing between these two tools. So the xTiles free plan basically includes unlimited blocks, 100 plus free templates, theme space, invite 10 guests, unlimited storage, 5 pages per project, and 3 spaces. So we just want to mention that the free plan with xTiles is a little limiting if you only have 5 pages per project. So what this means is that if you have this template on and you click this enough times, if you're doing a daily planner and you've already reached your 5 pages, you can't add any more daily plans here. So that could be a bit limiting, although you can also just plan all of your content into 5 different pages, which could potentially save you the need from upgrading the plan. Notion in that sense is very generous in that aspect that if you don't have a paid plan, you can still have unlimited blocks, unlimited pages, and things like that. So a lot of the limitations come with being able to use it more of a team use, and that's when you might want to consider upgrading, or if you have a need to upload bigger files. So next, let's go over the starter package, which is the most popular. So here we have unlimited personal spaces pages, premium templates, and basically then you get the unlimited. So in general, $5 is a very reasonable amount if you want to really make use of xTiles and you have all of these possibilities. And if you wanted the plus plan, it's $8.25 per month. And this is also quite nice because you get the advanced color options, timeline view, team templates, and so on. So xTiles is still being developed and there's a lot of potential here. So in general, we would recommend you to at least try it out and see if it could be worth it for you. Now, if we go over to Notion's pricing plan, you can see that the free plan has all of these options. And then if you're in the plus plan, it's going to be $10 a month. So if we compare it to xTiles, that's double the price of the second tier of xTiles. So in that sense, it could be more cost effective to use xTiles if you're trying to do something more simple with your personal planning and brainstorming and things like that. But if you need more powerful features, Notion could be able to do a lot more with its integrations and even the business and enterprise plans. So here are our final thoughts. Both tools could work well depending on your needs. But Notion is great if you want to organize complex data and pages in an all-in-one space. xTiles could be the right option as a simpler, more visual and intuitive tool, and it could work well for simple planning and brainstorming. We have templates for both tools and we encourage you to try them both to see which one resonates most with you. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to let us know, and we hope to see you all in the next video.